stage Diana Brown and Dan Wilson in Bingewatch!
Yay!
Can we go ahead and have something? Let's go with the mysterious music for this.
Yes!
And welcome to the spy who shagged somebody else.
Oh! On this stakeout, I didn't expect to find you here.
Well,
I'm glad I did.
You know, I've been watching you for a long time. Spies, watching other spies.
Watching other people not knowing they're being watched by spies.
Sometimes they even dance. It's disturbing to watch that. It's rather unnatural. Look, you should know that even though we're different agencies, you're FBI, I'm CIA, I think we could do a joint action together.
That sounds dirty.
Sure.
Talking. Look, I'm a spy. I don't get out much. I stay in, peer through my blinds. Technically, I've been on suspension. I had to turn in my gun, my badge, my binoculars. So I'm relegated to peering through my blinds.
That makes you perfect. You're off the grid. Come join me with the agency. We can work together. You have skills I've never seen before because they don't train us that way.
Hey, my mama gave me these skills.
And God bless America for it.
Herschel? The woman with the blinds is not doing the thing with the blinds anymore.
Well, you're watching the neighbors all the time.
The neighbors are watching me. I watch the neighbors watch me. It's a symbiotic thing.
Watch that Rear Window movie on American Movie Channel. You've been obsessed with peering through the windshield and all in the windows and wherever there's glass, you're only peering.
Stop yammering and give me the Windex.
Really? You break one leg and then suddenly you can do all the chores. Sure, why not? Marshall can get things.
Marshall, get that thing I asked you to get me. What did I ask you to get me? God, my mind is going. Inside voice, outside voice. Fuck is an inside. Oh, never mind. Give me the fucking Windex.
Why don't you just come to bed? We can do that thing we haven't done in years.
It's not just one leg that's broken.
Someone's gonna catch one of these days. They're gonna call the police. Like the real police.
Give me your undershirt.
Oh, well, it's about time. Put your arms out. Oh, Rit, that's nice. You're going to use it as a rag.
I did use it as a rag. Now I can see the neighbors seeing me see them. But she's not there. The little peery girl with the blinds is gone.
Look at me for once.
Maybe if you were on the other side of the glass, I'd have more interest. Something about not quite being able to touch, but being so close.
Keep talking.
So it's something about not being able to touch, but being so close. It makes me feel a certain amount. Where'd you go? Herschel? My nephew showed me that movie.
Come close. Can you hear me from the window?
I can read your lips.
The glass is really thick.
That's amazing.
Look, just for once, you're going to go across the entire picture window, really.
I wanted to get some perspective.
Stop. The I what they're doing.
You're blocking the view!
That's it, it's over.
No, it's just teasing! ruins a moment better than poor planning.
So, what I'm thinking is we can go ahead and spy on the RNC. Look, they've already got the Russians working for them.
That's true.
We have to do our part.
We're going to spy in the Republican National Convention.
Well, behind the scenes. I mean, God knows it's hard enough watching it from the front.
Thank you. I mean, I signed up to watch a lot, to deal with some dirty, ugly things, but you know, that man's face is orange. Or this chair. This face, this chair.
Not talking to his face.
When you're right, you're right.
We are two trained spies, and there's something between us other than just politics.
Huh? Maybe the fact that whenever I make a tuna fish sandwich and I put in extra relish, I think of you. I think I'm all pickled inside.
You know, for a world-renowned spy on suspension for possibly criminal acts, you're a real peach.
Without pit, right?
It's okay.
Oh, I gotta tell you, I use an exfoliating mask made out of the pits of the peach, and I feel like an athlete when I wear it.
You can't be distracted from the job.
It's so easy for me to get distracted from the job when I look in your deep, agey blue. No!
We have to focus. We have to make sure the election runs smoothly. Through acts of illegal espionage.
Now you're speaking my language. That I can do. Why didn't you say I've got a kit?
You know, that was the FBI.
Oh, no, of course not.
I mean, we have files.
Yes, you do.
Microphones. Warrants. But that's high tech.
Well, it's made out of lipstick, hair dryer. And a little bit of tinfoil.
Excellent. If we can get this to a Fox News correspondent's handbag, they'll take it to the convention.
Honey, you can get anything into a Fox News correspondent's handbag. Believe me, it's a more open and shut, never mind. Reminds me of a particular psychic I once knew. Madame Crystal.
You've seen more of the world than I ever have.
Oh, I can show you things. I can show you things even without this thing here. But the transmitter has to go in the bag of that Fox News correspondent, the one with the hair up to here, the boobs out to there.
No, down a little bit.
She's on at 7 p.m.
Ah, got it. Fine. Can you get that in there?
Well, I was counting on you getting it in there. After all, nothing like a ginger to get a Fox News correspondent hot and heavy.
But you'll monitor the whole thing, right? You'll know what's going on?
Just don't kiss her.
If I do, it won't be consensual.
I don't know which side to feel bad for in that case, but okay.
I'll be thinking of you. Agent.
Okay. Agent.
Still, there's been no one over there for 2 weeks.
I missed them.
Oh. You know, it's been hard. We never had kids.
They were like my kids.
I know. They were young and attractive and, well, I'm assuming, I mean, you would give me blow-by-blow descriptions as I lie in bed waiting for you every night.
Blow-by-blow is really the operative word. They had a Roomba, and they also had a hairdryer. There were things being sucked and blown everywhere. Dirty minds, dirty minds. Love that.
I've been thinking about going back to work.
Oh?
I want to get involved in politics.
Running for office?
Yeah, that's a young man's game. I'm thinking about maybe being a lobbyist.
For what?
depressed old Jewish men. One niche group were very powerful. And I think Bernie Sanders might be joining us soon.
He needs a hobby. To get off that poor woman's skirt. Leave her be, for God's sakes. She gets the nomination and her husband's on the paper. What are you going to do?
I'll be gone for a long time. Late hours.
Wait a minute. You're telling me you're going to... Oh, that hurts. Give me a chance to miss you? That's all I was looking for. A chance to miss you. You used to get up every day and go out to work with a jaunt in your step and a charming smile. It was like watching an episode of... Oh, fuck, I can't even remember. But the important thing was you looked happy. And I was proud. And then I would wait here all day and I would kill time spying on the neighbors. And you'd come home with a spring in your step and a smile. And you'd tell me about your day and I'd stop spying on the neighbors.
If I'd known I'd hear that affection in your voice, I'd have left you a long time ago.
Say it again.
Goodbye.
Oh. I don't think I've ever loved you more than I do right now.
Excuse me, Miss O'Malley. Hi. I gotta say, I've loved your work covering the convention so far. It has been more fair and balanced than I've ever really come to expect from you.
I have no idea what you're saying, but I like it.
Yes, well, not a lot of folks understand the importance of the regional Fox affiliates, and I think your work in the South has really brought the whole region together in a way that only the Bible has before now.
Sugar, let's pray together.
Sure, absolutely.
I can't get on my knees because I got new stockings on, but the Lord knows I'm bending, even when I'm not.
That's fine.
So put your hand out.
Okay.
And I'll put mine on top of yours, and we are for the moment. A king and queen of God.
Absolutely.
In his kingdom, dear God, we call upon you this day. So please, please come down and fill us, not in a dirty way.
Sorry, I don't know what I it's a twitch I have. It's a twitch I have.
The Lord can heal that. Let me lay on hands.
Okay.
Let me lay on hands a little.
Whoa! I respect you as a journalist.
And I respect you as a red-blooded American. I've always wanted to get my hands on some Berkeley meat.
I trust you. I'm with the Law Cabinet Division of the GOP. That means they're gay.
Because they're strong, dirty minds.
I just wanted to let you know how I felt about you, but I can see you're a busy, busy person.
Wait a minute,
I
no!
What I have to do here.
Hold on! If I can turn you straight...
Oh, boy.
Power I'd have. Hell, I could become a network anchor. Fuck small town life. I could go all the way to covering the Washington Bureau, or...
Get me out of here.
All you need's a good Southern woman to lay you down by the river. Read to you the words of the Bible written in red. And to take you and your man fruit up to heaven. To be blessed by God's own healing abilities to cure the sick, the weak, and the poor slightly homosexual.
Don't you have a convention to cover? Other things you need to worry about at this particular moment? Anything at all? Just top of your mind. Anything at all?
Well, Pokemon Go.
Anything.
Oh, yes, I didn't want to catch that little bugger. Where's my purse?
No.
Where the hell is my handbag?
It's hanging. It's a twist behind your back a little bit.
Oh, it's so much upon me now.
No, don't even look in there. Everything's...
I caught it. Oh, I don't know what the hell that is. It looks like my husband, but I'm going to catch him. Come on.
You're worthless. You're looking for a politician. Anyone will do.
Well, I'm technically a politician.
Really? Are you somebody that I could work for to make the world a better place for the cranky and depressed?
Well, I'm cranky when I don't get enough potassium. And I'm depressed because I've never had sex in my life. But besides that, I don't know. I'm apparently a representative here, representing apricots. Cotco. I have posted a blog about the wonderfulness of apricots. God, my life is boring.
They always say you don't want to see how the sausage is made, but politics is a far more drowned thing than I realized.
But you know, I have an in with the prune industry.
Really?
And I know you people like prunes, being old people. I wasn't commenting on your race, creed, or color. Race, color, what's the diff anyway? Back to
color. Well, color would refer to melanin content, whereas race might refer to country of origin.
I think you're onto something there.
I'm an old man, I'm very educated.
You know shit, don't you?
Well, I've had many years to read things and watch lots of Discovery Channel.
See, I'm from the everybody gets a trophy generation. I even got one. Go figure.
What was it for?
I don't even remember. All I know is they yanked me out of class. I was reading a copy of Harriet the Spry and they pinned something on my chest and said, "You got a medal! Because everyone gets one!" Stupid as fuck. Everyone shouldn't get a damn medal.
You're right.
I should have earned it. I never earned a damn thing in my life. Now I'm a politician of sort.
Well, you're a bureaucrat. A political bureaucrat.
A cog in a machine. Worthless.
You know, I came here to maybe help the Democrats or more of the disenfranchised Republicans who don't know what the fuck's going on. But maybe we should begin our own party. The No One Gets a Medal Party.
Unless they earn it.
Even if they do, they don't get a medal.
I like that.
Because they should know that the work is its own reward.
You'll never get that one past the Liberals. There's a cookie at the end of every rainbow. Yeah, look, we've got a graphic up now, let's see. There's the rainbow there. Oh, I've got some in my lunchbox. Scooby-Doo, get the crap beat out of me every day for carrying my Scooby-Doo lunchbox, so I'll be damned if I'm letting it go now.
I don't want to violate any HR policies, but you've never had sex before in your life.
Nope, not even once.
It's one of those little facts that kind of flew by really fast, but it seemed really important.
But you've had a ton of sex.
Well, not lately.
No.
I'm married. I've been married for 35 years. After the first 7, you start just watching Netflix. It's always the next episode, and the next episode, and the next episode, and then it asks, are you still watching? Of course you're still watching! That's what you're supposed to be doing.
I once had a Russian mail order bride. She never showed up.
That's hard.
Now I'm tweeting about apricots. Tangy! Oddly small and yet full of flavor. Not peach, but peach colored. I'm talking about characters. I'm just gonna put zingy there. No one cares anyway.
I didn't know it would be more exciting than this.
You're old enough to know better.
It's true, I am. Look, I can't help you directly, but have you considered that Tinder thing?
Swipe left, swipe right?
I'm assuming so. Let those Pokemon go.
No, let's swipe up.
Oh.
I should try to catch something.
I just know what I see on the news. Look, I came here to induce change in the world. Maybe I can't change the country, but maybe I can help you.
Then you get me laid.
I can point you towards the apps I've read about on incendiary websites. They say America's going to hell because of it, and so maybe it'll help you.
I've been swiped left so many times. I feel like a window.
You know, my wife could help you.
Really?
She likes to look at people. It gives her all kinds of ideas. She could do your makeover.
I'd like a makeover.
Why don't you come home with me? But only for reasons of helping you. I don't want you to get the wrong idea.
I'm bringing my lunchbox.
I'm coming with Thurio.
I know what that means.
I'm glad to hear it. Education isn't completely ruined in this country.
There's one thing I can offer you. Frequent flyer miles. I'm taking a bus.
I've never been to Israel. I'd like that.
Okay, we'll pop over to Israel before. Where did you say you
were? No, not before. My goodness gracious, we have to go and get you laid first.
Oh, my God, I was beginning to wonder.
I'm a man of my word. I would not take you to the Holy Land without getting you good and righteously fucked first.
You understood for the first time in my life. Let me just sign off the computer here.
Where the hell were you?
Agent?
Where were you? I kept talking into my goat and you didn't come.
She had
her paws all over me and she smelled of baby powder.
Avarice baby powder? You know, they've proven that baby powder causes... Never mind.
Mm-hmm. Look, I thought we could be partners in this, that we could be a team. But you just left me out there, hung me out to dry.
I hung you out to dry because I knew what was going to happen and I thought... She deserved to have the opportunity.
Oh, no more with the lapels. You pulled me close for a not quite kiss enough times already. You're a tease. You're a torturer. God, you're CIA.
Do you know what CIA stands for?
I think I do, but I'm guessing I'm wrong.
You do.
Okay. I've been drawn to you for years, and... Between our agencies, it's always been a bit of a flirtation, a push or pull. We do investigation, you do really dark, deep shit.
Yeah, we do. It's part of who we are and how we have to be. It's part of while we're watching someone and they know they're being watched and they're watching us back while we're all watching. We all know that it's just one giant watching peep show. What did I say?
I don't even know anymore. There's no transcripts.
We don't allow that anymore in the CIA. I just have to put spy life behind me. I can't be with you and I can't be part of the CIA and... Well, I guess I just have to go out there and be one of the watched. An average person. No badge. No agency. No sweet, sweet lapels to grab on.
No. I can't deny the pull between us. But I need to know I can trust you. Actually trust you? Can the FBI truly trust the CIA? Can the public ever actually trust either of us? Should they?
No.
What kind of relationship can there be with no trust?
Half the marriages in America?
That's why Ashley Madison's doing so well.
I guess this is where we say goodbye.
I really looked forward to investigating you thoroughly.
I really looked forward to a full report that I could pore over. But maybe, on another night, in another place, in another episode, we'll meet again.
I'd like that.
So would I.
No badges this time. We'll just watch each other across a distant room. Wearing sunglasses.
Knowing we're watching each other. And watching each other watch each other. Knowing.
We're watching each other, yes. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Honey, I'm home! I brought a friend!
I was watching out the window. They were parking the car.
Oh, they're back. That's nice. I hope they enjoyed whatever they were doing. Come on in. Come on in. I'd like you to meet my wife.
Okay, I've got my lunchbox here. Oh, well, you're a fetching, vivacious woman. I love that house coat.
Thank you. I haven't taken it off in 12 years. Stop lying. Shut up, you old cunt. So, you're the new young thing. So, you're the new young thing? The new one brought in here so we can flout you in front of me and make wild love while I watch you on the couch?
This is more than I bargained for.
No, let me explain. She gets a little excited sometimes. This is not that kind of thing, honey. Damn it. Look, I just thought...
Here, let me talk to her.
You do that.
Look, the thing is, he really likes you. He just wants a little more action. Action, he wants. Yeah, he just wants... He said he'd get me laid. Not with you. Don't get excited. Could send him across the street to the neighbor.
This is not a... No, look. I just... You watch people. You know what turns them on.
Oh.
What gets them excited.
True.
And she needs a little help in this area. For once, let your spying do some good and bring some love into the world.
Well, okay.
I don't mean to be preachy about it, but we're getting short on time.
Commercial coming on. Listen. Hold on, kid. Jesus, your pants. All right.
Where the fix did go?
I think the kid just needs to get rid of the glasses, get some contact lenses, and learn to dance. We can show him. Remember? We used to dance.
Sure.
Come on.
Okay.
Stand up. Take heed.
All right.
You want to romance somebody.
It's a little difficult with the crutch.
I think using it as a crutch, throw it aside, you'll need
it. What are you, a faith healer now?
Just do
fine.
It. Now you approach the lady.
All right, hold on. I need to put my weight on you. Okay. If only we could have some romantic type music playing about now, it would be nice. It would
be nice.
It would be nice. Well, take off your glasses and watch how we do this.
I feel 20 again.
But no more spying, okay?
From now on, the only person I'll be